Welcome to Nugget 107 with Steve Grohman, and we're going to continue our compromise series. And today we're going to ask, are you willing to compromise Genesis with evolutionary biologists? And this is the one I think that people most readily say, absolutely not.
Well, that is what they say. For the most part, that's the way people are. They don't want to do that, that's for sure. Well, let's see how Merriam-Webster defines biology. Biology is a branch of knowledge that deals with living organisms and vital processes, the plant and animal life of a region or environment, and the life processes especially of an organism or group. Medical definition is a branch of science dealing with living organisms and vital processes, the plant and animal life of a region or environment, and the laws and phenomena relating to an organism or group.
It's about the same.
About the same. Biology basically is the study of living things.
Lesson 8, Darwin's Legacy, goes into great detail about evolutionary biology and the evolutionary biologist and geologist before and after Darwin. He's still the kingpin of evolution.
Yes, and they say all life goes back to a single common ancestor, but the Bible does say, even in the New Testament, 1 Corinthians 15, verse 39 says, all flesh is not the same flesh. There's one kind of flesh of men, another flesh of beasts, another of fishes, and another of birds.
And the Bible does go on to say in Exodus 20, verse 11, which is in the middle of the Ten Commandments, for in 6 days the Lord made heaven and earth, the sea, and all that in them is, and rested the seventh day. Wherefore, the Lord blessed the Sabbath day and hallowed it. And I know you use this verse just repeatedly, pointing out everything, all that is in the heaven, that is in the earth, and that is in the sea, which covers everything, was made in that 6 day time frame. There is no evolution.
No, there is no evolutionary time given here, obviously, and thy word is truth, John 17, 17. Since the Bible is true, then there is no way that anything could have evolved up from some other creature. It just doesn't make sense.
And more specifically, in Genesis 1:21, it says that God created great wells and every living creature that moveth, which the waters brought forth abundantly after their kind, and every winged fowl after his kind, and God saw that it was good. He is making whales, and he's making birds. And what do the evolutionists say?
Well, the evolutionists say that the birds, obviously they came from something previous to them. If you look at the chart of life, how they say life evolves, everything goes back to a common ancestor. The bugs, the worms, the lobster, the plants, the pine tree, everything goes back
fungus
to a single common ancestor with us. And that just, in my mind, that seems pretty preposterous.
This is an amazing chart. It is one of the busiest ones that I've seen. But what I found most amusing was at the top of the chart where humans come in, they put as the man, they put Charles Darwin.
And it's his tree of life. It's his thinking idea in the first place. So he's definitely given credit for it.
I just think that's a little amusing.
It is funny. It is funny. But he's in the lineage with everything else, you know, the bunny rabbits and the possum and the
snakes. If he wants to come from a gibbon, so be it.
I guess, if he wants to feel that way. Science News ran the lucky ones. Of all the early birds, only one lineage survived. Wonder what lineage they came from.
Yeah, and they talk about how birds have evolved from the dinosaurs. That's ridiculous because the Lord created the beast.
Right.
On day 5 and 6.
And they reproduce after their kind.
Yes, they do. And the fowl was created on day 5 as a separate,
and they reproduce after their kind.
Kind.
And you know what's interesting? I do this a lot, at least once in every series of services we do at a church. I'll pick out some 4 to 9-year-old and ask them, technical question, if a dog has a baby, what's it going to be? And they always look at me really sheepishly like, man, is this a trick question or what? And they'll kind of look down and grin and they'll say, a puppy? Every time, truth is in there. Everything reproduces after its kind is exactly what everybody knows as little kids even. And then they grow up and we get taught birds came from dinosaurs
and
people
believe. Started with it, and people love
it.
Kids love dinosaurs, and they're always putting this idea in there, and they eventually start believing it.
It's kind of a sad reality because Darwin at one time was a 4, 5, 6, 7-year-old boy too, and he knew the truth.
He knew a chicken gave birth to a chicken.
Absolutely, everybody, no matter how staunch an evolutionist they are, everybody knows the truth back in their history, back when they're 4, 5, 6, 8, 10 years old, in that range there, and that truth has to be removed for this kind of a lie to be placed back in.
Back to that busy chart, here is where you can see, actually, in their tree of life that they present in textbooks and all different science biology courses, they have the dinosaurs and the birds on the same limb.
Right. They had to evolve from each other. Just absolutely no evidence for any of that.
Somehow, I doubt that your favorite penguins and my favorite flamingos came from any dinosaur.
No, I don't think so.
We had discussed this article a few nuggets back. It was Scientific American, June 2020, The Unexpected Origin of Fingers. And they're talking about this fish that they call our great great grandfish. It's a 380 million year old fish that gave us digits. This was one interesting statement that they made in this article.
Yeah, they say, in science, however, knowledge is not written in stone. It is subject to change in light of fresh new evidence. New discoveries can necessitate revision of the textbooks. And that's the kind of thing I've been talking about for all this time. They can sell this stuff off as a fancy fairy tale or science fiction if they want to. Just like the stuff of yesteryear that they taught was factual at that time, this stuff that they're teaching factual, it's not science. It doesn't qualify. And they just keep throwing this new stuff up, but it's still the same old stuff repackaged.
I think it's kind of ironic about this is they are using what they are thinking of as a cliche. It's not written in stone. I wonder if they realize that what's written in stone is the Ten Commandments, and
written.
It is that everything was made in 6 days. We just need to grin at that. They were trying to make a point, and the point is actually ours to make.
This point is ours to make. But again, all these textbooks throughout all years, they just come up with the same thing. It's all common ancestor stuff. They just rewrite it and revise it, and they realize something new, but yet it's still the same thing. In fact, this BBC article talking about the secret of how life on Earth began. Well, they say today life has conquered every square inch of Earth, but when the planet formed, it was a dead rock. So how did life get started? That's a valid question. So I know you like this. Darwin had an idea. It began where?
In a warm little pond.
Isn't that cozy?
Yes.
Sounds like a fairy tale.
Yes, it is.
God says, let the earth bring forth the living creature after his kind, the cattle, creepy things, and beasts of the earth after his kind. And it was so. And that's what we see. Written thousands of years ago, still confirmed to be true all over the place all the time. But yet the textbooks they put out today are wrong tomorrow. It's amazing.
And again, God made us in his image. And he gave us dominion over all the animals.
Yes, I think we should never, ever compromise Genesis with any of these evolutionary biologists.
Absolutely not. Well, thank you.